Hey you, I'm Jules, and I have a short torso. You may have already known that given all the short torso videos I do. Now you may be asking, Jules, why the voiceover? Well friend, I'm looking for dramatic effect. Because this video is all about things you should avoid if you have a short torso body type like me. Actually, these are things that are hard to avoid. So maybe a better term is pay attention to these things. They're not off limits, but they're important to making or breaking an outfit. The first thing you really want to be aware of are any lines that are created across your body. So this could be when you're wearing a top and pants, whether you're wearing longer pants or shorter pants, where do your sleeves come on your arms. Don't know why that was so hard for me to remember. What your neckline is looking like, any patterns that are creating lines. This could be texture patterns, color patterns. And while I am saying you don't need to avoid lines, it is easier when lines work in your favor. So for example, there's the line between high-rise pants and crop tops. That is going to be a particularly difficult line for a short torso to feel like they're proportionate in versus if they were to wear more mid-rise to low-rise jeans and just like a top that fits. But let's take that a step further. Let's say you are wearing pants that match the top that you're wearing, but it has a stripe that cuts you right here. Let's just say right across your rib cage, and it's one color up here and kind of a similar color to your pants down here. That line is going to create the same effect as the high rise and the crop top. Now again, we are paying attention to lines because you cannot avoid lines unless you're wearing a wetsuit. And even then there's a couple lines. The second thing to pay attention to is the contrast between those lines. If those lines are the same color, chances are that line is not very noticeable, adds some texture, adds some interest. But if there's a lot of contrast in those lines, then that line and those colors and that contrast are really impacting your proportions. Let's take that same example of just wearing those low to mid-rise pants with just a normal shirt. If you are wearing black pants and a white shirt, obviously that's a lot of contrast, and that in and of itself is going to create that line much more prominently across your torso. Similarly, tonal outfits lessen the contrast between things. So if you're wearing a dark brown thing with a light brown thing or a light beige thing with a dark beige thing, that is going to just create some texture and not as obvious of a line as black and white. Again, we can't avoid lines, but maybe when you have a pair of black jeans that are more high rise, you don't pair it with a white shirt. This is another reason why all one color outfits work so well for short torsos, because it just sort of blends all those lines together. So pay attention to the colors and contrast that you're creating with your outfits. And you know I talk about that a lot, especially when it comes to necklines, so make sure to watch some of my other videos if you haven't seen me talk about it yet. The third thing to pay attention to are tops that are overly complicated. Now, in some of my earlier videos, I definitely recommend, and I still stand by, creating emphasis and interest in the areas that you want the eye to go. So if you want the eye to go to your face, curl your hair. If you want to create more emphasis around your neck, wear a necklace, those kind of things. But when it comes to tops, if a top itself is too complicated, if there's too many interesting parts, if there's buttons, flutter sleeves, a peplum, that might be overwhelming and it just creates more opportunities for it to not fit your short torso frame. Now, if you're willing to put in the effort and go get it tailored so that all of those complications can fit you, then that's great. But if you're looking for something that's easy, easy to buy and just know what's going to fit, those overly complicated tops aren't going to be your friend. Because also remember that when you're looking at something online and you're thinking, oh, that top is super cute, it's a little complex, but look at how those details look on the model. Those same details are likely, unless you're tall with a short torso, but they're likely going to be shortened in between each other. And so they might actually fall on top of each other, which can take away from that effect. The other thing to pay extra attention to the point of avoiding if you can't do it, but at the same time, like, again, there's all kinds of nuance here, is bras that can't forever tighten. And what I mean by forever tighten means that when you need to tighten your bra strap, it doesn't run into some structural part of the bra that can't go within the little tightening thingamajig. Because as you wear your bra, it's going to stretch out and you're going to need to tighten those straps over and over and over again. And as the years go by, you're gonna need more and more room in that strap. Now, some people would say, well, when it hits that part, you need a new bra. Do you? If everything else in the bra is working except for the straps, do you really need a new bra? And I'm probably gonna start getting some hygienic comments about, well, yes, there's probably bacteria deep in the bra, and I honestly don't wanna know. So by having straps that you can always keep tightening, That's really important because, and maybe I should have mentioned this earlier, you want your girls to be lifted off of your torso as much as possible. You always want your straps to be really tight. Not so tight that it's creating marks or that it's uncomfortable, but tight so that they're lifted up. Again, there are two ways to create length in your torso, and that is down and up. By lifting the girls up, you're creating a little bit of extra space right there. The other thing to keep in mind, which I know completely contradicts my point here and my points everywhere and other people's points everywhere, but it's don't always take style advice, including from me. And I only say that because it's only true, because there is so much nuance when it comes to style. It's so subjective. And here on YouTube, for example, because I'm assuming you're watching this on YouTube, maybe you're not, but there are so many videos out there of do this, don't do this, and mentions of, oh, if you wear something like this, that's out of trend or that looks frumpy. And to be honest, I don't think that is always true. There's little room for nuance when it comes to this, and yet there can be subtle differences between all of our bodies where that particular detail can be really helpful for your body, but someone might be trashing it in another video. And I'm by no means slamming other creators, because clearly I do it too, but I'm just encouraging you to take style advice and see if it fits your body and feel okay saying, you know what, that doesn't work for my body. That doesn't mean it's bad style advice. It just means it doesn't work for your body. There is no one size fits all style advice that can work for everyone. But if you do have a short torso, I try my best to give as much short torso styling advice as I can. So make sure you watch this video next, and thank you so much for being here. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I can't wait to see you in my next video. Bye.